The signs are printed up. They say they're Bernie supporters, but you know who runs Chicago, the Clinton crime machine with Rahm Emanuel. Roger Stone, thank you so much for coming back on.
Jonathan Lewis, the mysterious and reclusive heir to the progressive insurance fortune, Peter Lewis, his late father, funding all kinds of left-wing schemes. These are the ringleaders and the financiers of this false flag attack on Trump. And their goal is twofold. One, to split off those economic voters who are currently for Bernie, but could very well end up with Trump because the international trade deals have put these folks out of work, have destroyed their livelihood, and they figured it out. Bill and Hillary pushed NAFTA. Now suddenly that she's running for president, she says, oh, she's changed her mind about NAFTA. Well, she won't change her mind about TPP or any of the upcoming international globalist trade deals. She cannot be trusted on this issue. And then secondarily, they want to brand Trump, as I wrote for Breitbart, as a bigot, a racist, prone to violence. This is an effort to alienate those blue-collar voters that we're talking about who are for Bernie today, but could end up being for Trump.
How is the overall fight going, Roger, right now? Clearly, they're shaving votes around the state. The state of Texas now admits they can't certify the election, but I'm sure the RNC will just do it at the convention. They're admitting fraud in Ohio. I mean, it's all coming out that there's fraud going on to shave points so that Trump doesn't get a clear majority and so they can sell the idea of a broker convention that you first warned of.
The Kansas voter fraud, the Maine voter fraud, the irregularities in Hawaii, in Ohio, the Trump ballot security project I'm working with is preparing a lawsuit to overturn the results of the Ohio primary in the event that John Kasich wins. And we have a very strong lawsuit based on the format of the ballot, which we believe was designed specifically to disadvantage Trump. There's a high probability that we would challenge the seating of the Texas delegates.
How is Donald feeling right now? He seems super energized. I love the fact that when he was in Ohio and that guy rushed the stage that says he wants to kill Trump, so he's a loving hero, such a man, that Trump didn't run from him or jump on the ground like most presidential candidates would. When the Secret Service tried to shield him and jump on him, he pushed him out of the way like he wanted to fight the guy.
Yeah, no, Trump is a tough guy. He's courageous. He knows he's taking his life in his hands. You can now see, which I said on this show again, that he has been forced to wear a bulletproof vest. Obviously, he knows that a headshot is a whole different issue. There's no question. To save his country, he is taking these enormous personal risks, but he is pumped up, he's energized, and he realizes more and more that this is a united globalist phenomena. You'll notice that Cruz and Rubio and Kasich, they sided with the Chicago protesters. They attacked Trump for inciting violence by speaking the blunt truth. So we know where they stand. Instead of defending free speech and the First Amendment, they piled on with Soros. That's because at the end of the day, they too are globalists. I know Ted Cruz does a great job of sounding like a constitutional conservative, but look at his background.
But Cruz comes out of their loins. His wife comes out of the bushes. He does. Goldman Sachs, top of the pyramid. Your article's on Daily Caller. Who is the real Heidi Nelson Cruz? And it's a very, very important article. What about this other one, Breaking?
That could be it, but I'll tell you what is definitely coming. There will be an attack on Trump that will say that as a developer and builder, he regularly bought concrete from a company controlled by the mob and Fat Tony Salerno, a gangster. Here's what they won't tell you. The city of New York also bought concrete from them. So did the state of New York. So did every other major developer in New York because they had a New York business license. See, they don't tell you that part. And why did everybody buy concrete from this one company? Because they were union-friendly. So Trump has done nothing wrong, but the insinuation will be, oh, he's mobbed up. He bought concrete from this one company. They're not going to tell you that so did the state of New York, so did Washington cabal, though. These senators begin to believe that they have some kind of inoculation. They believe they're above the law. The power, the money, the women, the sex, it all comes as part of the package.
We bring up the mainstream media investigating whether Ted Cruz has got girlfriends on the side. And what I said here is, I'm not giving that a pass. What I am saying is, how can the Clintons Bill be raping women, Hillary covering it up, Hillary with all these women around her, you know, staying in her hotel room, you know, she's known bisexual, probably just a lesbian, whatever. I don't even get into that issue. But why being a protected group sexually, like a lesbian, is she allowed to then cheat on her husband? But if Ted Cruz is cheating on his wife, then it's bad. She, I mean, it's like crazy how the left gets passes on everything. Drudge is always, you know, pointing out who her girlfriends are. And the media acts like he's making that up. It's known that she's seen more tail than a, you know, toilet seat. So I'm asking you right now, where do you think all this shakes out in the election, them coming after Trump? I know he's owned it, you know, getting off his jet with a bunch of beautiful women from the pageant. I know he's, you know, in between, you know, divorces, had girlfriends, big deal. You know, the guy doesn't hide it. In 3 minutes, closing remarks, I'm concerned about that down the road.
Yeah, I think that there are greater concerns. I have a greater concern for his personal safety, to be honest with you, because this is a non-starter. There's no question whatsoever that Trump had numerous beautiful and glamorous girlfriends in between his marriages. But the issue here is not marital infidelity, and it's not adultery. In the case of the Clintons, it's something much darker. It's rape. It's sexual assault, in which Hillary has been an accessory in all of those sex crimes. Because as you know, and as I establish in my book, The Clintons' War on Women, Hillary is the one who runs the campaign to intimidate and bully and terrorize these women out of testifying or out of going public.
Sure.
He's not going to cower. It's just not his nature. So, you know, we pray for him every day. We pray for his safety because this is the last best hope for Western civilization. This is the last best hope for the sovereignty of the American people. Is Trump perfect? No, he's not perfect.
Well, I'll say this. It makes me like him even more that he went at the attacker and that he's not a coward. And I know full well the Secret Service is telling him, stop these big rallies. There's too